Hello everyone, this is Dr. Schumailla Bassi, MBBS and MS Obs in Gynec, working as Consultant Gynecologist at Cloudnine Hospital, Ludhiana. Now, heart diseases in pregnancy are not very common, but if you get them, then they give you bad complications. Now, we all know that heart is a four-chambered organ, and between the chambers, there are some valves, like it is in a pipe that carries water. So most common heart disease in pregnancy are the valvular heart diseases, in which the most common one is mitral stenosis. We have two valves between four chambers. One is the mitral valve and the other is the aortic valve. So this mitral valve, it gets stenosed, it gets narrowed, or these valves, they get open up and they cause regurgitation. That means when the heart pumps the blood to the parts of the body, instead of going forward, the blood comes back to the previous chamber. That's called regurgitation. So mitral and aortic stenosis and regurgitation are the valvular heart diseases. The second kind of heart diseases are the congenital heart diseases, which depict in the adult life, especially in pregnancy. Third kind of heart diseases are the cardiomyopathies, in which the heart shows dysfunction due to viral infection, autoimmune antibodies, due to obesity, due to hypertension, due to drugs that you use. And the fourth kind of heart diseases are the pulmonary hypertension, in which the heart shows abnormality and there's hypertension in the pulmonary vessels, that is the vessels of the lungs. Now, talking about the most common heart disease, mitral stenosis, mostly the first and the second trimester stays okay, because the body adapts to it. In the third trimester, we have lot of volume overload. The blood volume increases, the output of the heart increases, the heart rate increases. And so our heart decompensates and we show sign and symptoms of whatever heart disease that we have. So in the third trimester, if any female is complaining about fatigue, chest pain, or cough, or dyspnea, that means difficulty in breathing, or she has swelling in the legs, or increased urination at night, or she's able to feel her heartbeat, or she's able to feel her pulse too much, then these signs and symptoms should not be neglected. We should not think that these are normal signs and symptoms of a pregnant lady and we should not view the heart. Now, adult echocardiography can be easily done in third trimester. It does not cause any problems to the baby. So going for an adult echo or an echo of a pregnant lady will let us know if she has any heart disease in pregnancy. Otherwise, if it is missed, then during delivery or postpartum period, it will lead to some complications. The most common heart disease since being mitral stenosis, it is mostly depicted in the third trimester during delivery or postpartum period. Why so? Because in the first and second trimester, our body during pregnancy, it compensates. But in the third trimester, there is increase in the blood volume, in the output of the heart, which is called the cardiac output, and also in the heart rate. Hence, our body, especially the heart, it decompensates or it shows signs and symptoms. Now, what are the common signs and symptoms of any heart disease in pregnancy? The most common is difficulty in breathing. Now, this difficulty in breathing is a very important symptom. It has four categories. Like if you have difficulty on very strenuous work, then it is called mild. If you have difficulty in breathing in normal activity, it's called moderate. If you have difficulty on just talking and on sitting and doing your normal work, it's called severe. And if you have difficulty in breathing even at rest, it is fourth grade of symptom, which should be really looked into. Most common symptom is chest pain or having cough or wheezing. Wheezing is when you can hear your breath sounds. The third most common symptom is feeling your heart rate. It is called palpitation, that I can hear my heart sounds or I can feel the heart beating into my chest. The fourth most common symptom is swelling. May it be over legs, then it can gradually increase to the thighs or the abdominal area or over the face. But leg swelling, since it is a common symptom of pregnancy, it should not be neglected and the heart should definitely be viewed if you have particular leg swellings till your knees or over your thighs. Now, other signs and symptoms can be increased urination at night, too much of fatigue, that you're not able to do your normal activity, or if you have too much pain in the chest radiating to your arm. Now, how you can diagnose that you have a heart disease? You go to your obstetrician, she will put a stethoscope and she will hear your heart sounds. If she hears any abnormal heart sounds, she will ask you to go for an echocardiography. Now, even if you don't have any abnormal heart sounds, but you have high risk factors like hypertension, diabetes, obesity, or your family member like your mother, father, or your sibling has a heart disease, then don't hesitate in asking your obstetrician to get your echocardiography done. Echocardiography can pick your heart diseases and will help you and your obstetrician to diagnose it at the right time and treat it also at the right time.